Hello, I'm Dr. Beth Colby from Talk Mental Health. Close your eyes for a moment and imagine yourself on a beach. You can feel the sun on your skin and a light breeze. You can feel the sand under your feet. You're eating an ice cream. What does it taste like? What colour is it? What are the sounds you can hear? 1 to 5% of the population are unable to imagine in their mind's eye and see mental images or pictures or sounds in their head or other senses. The condition they have is called aphantasia. I said they're unable to see pictures in their mind's eye. However, this is voluntarily, such as trying to recall events or images or imagine things. However, 2/3 of people with aphantasia are able to dream or have involuntary images flashed in their mind whilst awake. Some people with aphantasia are unable to visualise or recall faces, which is particularly upsetting if somebody has lost a loved one. This condition is known as prosopagnosia, and you can see my video on that if you're interested. Aphantasia was only recently coined in 2015, and it is a condition that is being studied closely now, having not been in the past. However, it was described towards the end of the 19th century. It is on a spectrum like other psychological conditions, and some people have no mind's eye. That's aphantasia. Other people have extra vivid imaginations in their mind's eye, and that's called hyperfantasia. And most people are somewhere in between. 10 to 15% of the population have hyperfantasia. Most people with aphantasia are born with it, i.e. it's congenital, but other people can acquire it, for instance, after a brain injury. So how does aphantasia affect somebody's life? People with aphantasia may have difficulty remembering certain things, such as how many windows, for instance, are in a building, because they can't picture it unless they've counted it whilst being in the vicinity. They may struggle to recall certain events, although they may be able to recall the date of a social gathering and how many people were invited. They may have difficulty imagining future. Having the condition does not appear to affect people's success in life. And certainly there have been many creative people or scientists, for instance, with aphantasia. Their mind just works differently and they may remember things using other parts of the brain. People with aphantasia have a different way of processing information. And even though they don't have a mind's eye, they may remember things using factual memory, knowledge, logic, numbers. Thank you for listening. Remember to like and subscribe. Bye for now.